Hi, I'm Tom Loschiavo, Education Manager here at PASCO Scientific, and I'm here today to introduce the wireless colorimeter and turbidity sensor. The colorimeter is great for measuring colored solutions, and the turbidity sensor is great for measuring the quality of water samples. So, let's take a look at what's in the box. When I open the box, there is a wireless colorimeter and turbidity sensor. There are cuvettes and two cuvette racks. There are 10 cuvettes total, 6 of them for use with the colorimeter, and 4 are 4 clear sides for use with the turbidity sensor. There is a 100 NTU standard for calibrating the turbidity sensor, and there is a USB cable for charging. So, first we are going to focus on the colorimeter. To do that, I'm going to connect it to my software, and I'm using SparkView software. So I'm going to turn on the colorimeter sensor, and I'm going to connect it via Bluetooth. And using the colorimeter, I'm going to test these prepared cuvettes. So my device pops up. I'm going to connect to it. After it connects, you'll notice that a prompt appears to calibrate the sensor. Calibration is an important part for colorimetry and turbidity, so it is recommended that you calibrate each time, and it is recommended that you instruct students to do so. If you are in a hurry, or if you know you calibrated very recently, you can hit cancel because the calibration is stored right on the device. But I'm going to walk through the calibration. So I hit calibrate, and I can calibrate either turbidity or colorimetry. In this case, I want to calibrate my colorimeter. And it instructs me about what to do. So I'm going to insert a blank cuvette, which is a cuvette with a solvent. I'm going to use the cuvettes that have ridges on the sides so that I don't touch the sample, touch the cuvette where the light is going to go through. And I'm going to put that into the colorimeter so the light goes through the clear side over to the detector. And I know that the detector is over here because of the rainbow. I'm going to put that in. I'm going to hit calibrate. And then, once it's calibrated, I get this green check mark. So again, a nice indicator for students and for you to know that something happened, and this is calibrated. And I'm going to hit done. And since I calibrated the colorimeter, my colorimeter measurements pop up on the home screen, and they're reading zeros for the absorbance and 100% for the transmittance, which is what you'd expect for the calibration. Now, I did want to introduce this with a quick start lab. So over here, under Spark Labs, there are quick start labs that are sensor specific. So if I click on this quick start tab, then I get a couple of quick start labs that are only for this wireless colorimeter. And the first one is a great introduction, that is absorbance and transmittance. If I click on that, then a page pops up. It's a bar meter display where my absorbances of the different wavelengths are across the bottom, and the absorbance value is on the y-axis. And those absorbance values on the bottom are in increasing wavelength order. So if I hit start, I see pretty much nothing, nice and zero across, because I have my blank in there. But now we can test some colored solutions. And you do want to make sure that you're wiping those cuvettes in between, and you pop them in. And there's my blue solution, and I'm going to use a graph tool to auto-scale that, and I'm going to put the number display, show values onto those bars also. Now you notice something interesting, and this is a great thing to teach your students and to have them figure out. You'll notice that the blue solution does not absorb mostly blue light. It actually absorbs mostly orange light. And this is one of the things you want to teach with a colorimeter, is that the complementary colors are what's important when you're talking about absorbance. So if you think about a color wheel, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and violet, that blue and orange are complementary colors. The reason this appears blue is because it's not absorbing blue, it's absorbing mostly the complementary color to blue, which is orange. And we can look at that if we compare a couple other samples. If I pop in a red solution, we'll see that's absorbing mostly the other end of the spectrum, the blues and the greens. If I put in a yellow solution, it's absorbing mostly violet. Again, thinking about that color wheel. And finally, if I put in a green solution, Now this one's interesting because it's absorbing lots of oranges and reds, and it's absorbing lots of violet. And that's because that green solution is a mixture of blue and yellow. So I'm getting both of those absorbance values in that mixture. All right, so we're gonna reset and we're gonna focus on the turbidity measurement of the wireless colorimeter and turbidity sensor. Now we're gonna focus on the turbidity measurement of the wireless colorimeter and turbidity sensor. We're gonna try to determine the turbidity of this unknown sample. So to do that, we are going to reconnect our sensor to SparkView. Since we have reset and reconnected, it is gonna prompt us to calibrate again. And that's good because calibration for turbidity is just as important as it is for colorimetry. I'm gonna go in. Since I'm prompted, I'm gonna hit calibrate. It is gonna pop up the turbidity sensor or colorimeter. I wanna make sure I'm calibrating with the turbidity sensor. And now it's gonna ask me to calibrate with two things. I'm doing a two-point calibration with my blank and a 100 NTU standard. So my blank is distilled water, which is a 0 NTU standard. And this is my 100 NTU standard. And that came from this bottle from the colorimeter and turbidity sensor box. So if you notice when I'm doing turbidity, you wanna make sure you're using the four-sided clear cuvettes. And that is because the turbidity measurements, the light is coming perpendicular to the detector. So I'm gonna use this four-sided clear cuvette. I'm gonna put in my blank or my 0 NTU standard. I'm going to hit calibrate. I get that check, so I know that the calibration is complete. I'm gonna take my standard, my 100 NTU standard. I'm gonna make sure it is mixed. There are instructions for mixing in the reference manual. And make sure the sides are clear. Put that in. And I'm going to calibrate. I get that check again, so I know calibration is complete. I'm gonna hit done. And now on my home screen, I wanna make sure I'm looking at the turbidity sensor measurements. So I'm gonna close the colorimeter. Make sure turbidity is open, and now I'm getting 99.5 NTU, about 100 that I standardized with, so that's great. My calibration took. Now I want to measure my turbidity of the unknown. So to do that, there isn't a quick start for this, but I'm just going to do a show path because I just need the measurement itself. I just want to look at the digits. So I'm going to click on turbidity. I get a graph right away. It's going to use this arrow to have a nice big display of my NTU. Still reading about 100 for my standard, which is great. I'm gonna, again, make sure this is nice and mixed according to the instructions. Make sure those sides are clear and clean. Put that in. And now I'm measuring about 58 NTUs for my unknown. The detector range is from 0 to 400 NTUs with an accuracy of about 5%. So if you are over 400, you will want to dilute your sample. And so this wireless colorimeter and turbidity sensor, great for looking at colored solutions. Applications include looking at concentration and color, and then also looking at reaction kinetics, where we can see dyes fading or reactants change in color over time. And the turbidity measurements are great for looking at the quality of water in terms of turbidity. So if you want to learn more about this sensor and any of our other wireless sensors, go to PASCO.com/wireless.